Hi, welcome to this video. I'm Niels Agoort, and I work for VMware in a cloud platform business unit. In this video, I want to discuss with you what is new with DRS in vSphere 7. Let's first take a quick look at what we did with DRS 1.0. And even though there's no real versioning in DRS, it's just DRS, let's stick with that name for the sake of this video. 1.0 or the DRS prior to vSphere 7, right? What we did whenever we had a VM in a cluster, so these are all ESXi hosts, right? And we used a cluster-wide deviation model, meaning that DRS wanted the hosts to be sort of equally utilized. So whenever we saw that we have, for instance, high memory pressure on this specific ESXi host, we could move the virtual machine that is responsible for that specific memory load, we could move that to a different host. In the end, what we wanted to do is sort of create that baseline that everything is equally utilized. Now, there's a lot of metrics that come into play with DRS, even with the older DRS that we used. But this is basically the model that we have been using since the inception of DRS. So DRS 1.0 or the older DRS was about cluster-centric. And important to know is that DRS by default runs each and every 5 minutes, okay? Now let's look what we changed up with vSphere 7 and already in VMC since the M9 release. So now if we look at what we have done with DRS in vSphere 7 or whenever you use VMC, VMware Cloud on AWS, we stepped away from the cluster-centric focus. So if we think about this as the DRS 2.0, and remember, it's not a version, it's just a way of explaining that this is the new version, the new way of doing things. It's just called DRS whenever you look it up in the UI, for example. Now, we are no longer cluster-centric, we are now workload-centric. Meaning that whenever we have a virtual machine running on an ESXi host, we calculate something that is called the VM DRS core. This is a new construct, basically. And we use this core to verify if a virtual machine is scoring enough, if it's happy enough, right? And we have several metrics to calculate the VM DRS core. The first ones are basically performance-driven. Think about CPU readiness time. Think about VM memory swap, about CPU cache behavior. All those metrics have a great impact on the VM DRS core. But it's not only about the performance as well. It's about the capacity of the ESXi host themselves, meaning that if we look in all the ESXi hosts in the cluster, we look at the headroom that a specific ESXi host has. So for instance, this ESXi host here has a lot of headroom, right? And that is also something that we incorporate into the VM DRS core. So can the application itself burst enough on the host that it is running on right now? So all these things basically, and there's a lot more metrics in the background as well, basically come up with that DRS, VM DRS core. Now we calculate that score for this specific virtual machine on each and every host in the cluster. And we will do so each and every minute. Remember, with the older version of DRS, we used 5 minutes. So it's far more granular approach, far more fine-grained. So whenever we have a virtual machine DRS core and we come up with, hey, this virtual machine is probably better off here, we'll also calculate the cost. the cost of moving that virtual machine with vMotion, if DRS is set to fully automated, the cost of the migration from this host to this specific host. In the end, we don't care so much about the specific utilization of all the ESX IOs themselves. It is really about the workload. And that is the biggest difference that we have compared to versions prior to vSphere 7. Thank you for watching.